every year I go to Magstock, and every year something else amazing I find. And this year it was a guy, Aaron, who had these interesting modules, and I recognized immediately the ESP8266 on it. And he was playing a game with it, with several people.
If you hold that in, that's the amount of time that the game has. Each blue dot is about a minute and a half. When the game's over, it'll blink and all that good stuff. Discuss among yourselves where you're going and if you're going in teams right now.
Huddle.
If it might be a strategy.
Huddle. Huddle.
Huddle.
Huddle.
Huddle. Huddle. Get some strats going. That way. So the way it works is there's two starting alpha zombies, and they have 30 seconds to count down, and everyone else scatters and hides amongst the area. After they're done counting down, they go out and try to find and chase down.
You guys have to hide your arms. 3, 2, 1, turn your device on. Turn your device on.
Oh God.
Don't kill yourself. Disperse, disperse. Hide, my friend.
And as more humans get converted into zombies, it's kind of a snowball effect.
Yeah.
Right. See what you
eventually.
Got zombified.
You haven't seen any filthy humans around here, have you?
Nothing but chickens. Chickens here.
It's a couple of
humans.
Yep,
I've seen it.
Popping up there. So the game lasts 15 minutes. And after that, you're either the surviving human and they haven't found you, or you've been turned into a zombie and you're out chasing the other humans.
Oh, no! No, you didn't try. Okay.
It's kind of like a Manhunt style game, but the interesting thing is that it's hide and seek, but it works very well because you have this proximity detector right here.
So if you get closer to a zombie, the lights will increasingly go up. And then if you get close, you'll turn into a zombie. By these indicators, will turn green.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's cool. So like the act of tagging is like logged electronically.
Yeah, exactly. They're like Wi-Fi. I don't know how it works. Something about Wi-Fi.
And so if it's really close, it turns.
Yeah, it'll go all the way up.
That blue. Okay. Is
what is blue?
Blue is how much time is left in the game.
Oh. Yeah. Okay.
So. So there's somebody.
No, just
that way the zombies can find you. It's a very interesting gameplay aspect with the ESPs. So this is a demo of it. So currently we have a human device here, and we have a bunch of green dots here. That means it's the enemy. And over here we have another device that's set up as a zombie. So we see it's green, and the zombie can also track the humans, and we see the amount of white dots here. So with this device, we're going to start bringing it closer, and we'll see the amount of dots increase on both devices, and eventually when it gets to about 1 foot radius, both of them turn green, indicating that, you know, this person has been changed.
Go.
So these are ESP8266 devices, and they're in AP plus station mode. And the neat thing is that they're not actually, it doesn't need an infrastructure. You don't need a Wi-Fi anywhere else. These can work in the woods or in a forest somewhere. They're broadcasting by themselves. And they're broadcasting the SSID, so either it's human or zombie. And all they're doing is they're scanning for other human and zombie SSIDs, so that's the way they get the signal strength. Just like you see the signal strength on your phone like when you're searching for Wi-Fi. So just based off of that, you can play this game anywhere outside. You don't need to be inside or near another Wi-Fi signal, and you can just continually add them on, and the game will just scale up. But yes, that's how the devices work themselves.
I know most of the videos I make are about things that I do that I think are cool, but every now and then I come across something that somebody else does that's just so awesome, especially when it has to do with the technology that I really enjoy using myself, like the ESP8266 here. So if you like this video, check out the link in the description, this Wi-Fi zombie-like game called SpyTag. Hope you guys liked it. See ya.